really the highlight of the day was the first media timeout. And play the football team's, I don't want to say miraculous, but I mean, really good outcome. And kind of look up and see that. And that was the highlight of the first half anyway, for sure. But congratulations to Brett and the guys getting a road win. You get a road win in the Big Ten, and it's always a great deal. But that was the highlight of the first half. I thought defensively we were pretty good. So I shouldn't even make light of the job we did. Shaw came in here. It's one of the top scorers in the country. Again, he got a little taste of Kyle Boswell. No points at half. I think they were 1 of 12 from 3. 15 points. I thought we did a much better job of making it difficult for him. I think he saw a lot of bodies. I thought Ben was much better in terms of giving support and helping, as well as Tommy was. But and then I thought KJ was everywhere. KJ had 4 steals in half. His hands on a lot of basketballs. We did a good job of just guarding them in a night that we didn't shoot the ball very well. So, it's nice to win 47 or 50, whatever it was, and shoot 25% from the 3. So, hats off to Trey. I thought Trey was outstanding in the first half, 8 rebounds, his energy. You start to see what he can do defensively when partnered with 2 other guys who are pretty good, and Kylan's exception. And it gives you size and athleticism. So I was very excited for Trey, and thought he did a really nice job on the defensive side. So then Perez had 6 at half, double-double. It's nice to see him get rewarded on the offensive side and do some positive things. But we need Perez. His 8 minutes and 4 fouls the other night at Alabama obviously changed a little bit of the outcome of that game. So we've got to have him playing smart and staying out of foul trouble, because he truly impacts us.
Brad, there was a play, and Ben Humrickhouse looked over the bench and says he's left hand, right? And it was like a scouting mistake right there. How much is that a part of some of the defensive struggles that you've had or prior to this game? Is just learning the level of scouting and the detail that goes into it?
Yeah, mistakes cost you at this level. A game in which most games are decided by a couple of possessions, you sure can't afford to have scouting report mistakes that you cover it and you work on it. And that's a player's responsibility, is to understand that. It's at least in our program. I don't want to say everybody does that, but I always go back to the Michigan game a few years ago with Io, and we had two scouting report mistakes the entire game. So it's getting guys dialed in. That's why I say the defensive side takes a little longer. That's why I was upset at Alabama. We don't give up middle drives very often, and Ben happened to be a big culprit of 3 or 4 of those. So it's just getting guys acclimated to what our fundamentals are and then handling the importance of managing a scouting report.
Coach, Kyle Boswell, obviously more assertive offensively these last 2 games. Is that something he had talked about with him, or something he took upon himself just to be more aggressive?
No, he's a really good player. And, he's a 40% career 3-point shooter. I mean, his ball's going to start going in. I want him to take shots that are the right shots within the framework of what we do, and that they're good quality shots. I want to see him continue to play off 2 feet. He's a guy that's, as a smaller guard, is not going to get away with playing off 1. When he plays off 2, he had 2 of them in the second half, he just went off 2 feet, and he got fouled. So it's just continuing the growth part of that for him, but it's being aggressive and knowing where his opportunities come from. I thought he and KJ both were aggressive early. We knew they were going to go under our ball screens, and for whatever reason, they're both good shooters and didn't make them.
You And Brad, today was the first time we saw Tommy and Merez on the court for an extended stretch. Merez mentioned earlier that the plan maybe was to try to get to Alabama, but his foul trouble kind of got in the way. What were you looking for?
Yeah, he pretty much screwed up his opportunities there for me to see what we were doing. We'd like to be able to play that. I mean, it gives us a tremendous advantage defensively. It gives us a different look than what we have with Ben. I think we can also slide Ben to the three and play bigger some. We've tried to look at some of those things, and like I said, today gave us an opportunity to look at a little bit of that. I also pretty much had a mindset if the game got out of hand, I didn't want to play anybody more than 24, 25 minutes either. So I kind of got a little hesitant to try to do that much in the second half.
Coach, you highlighted Moran's in a double-double. I wanted to get your thoughts on just the play that he had there with the end one, just not giving up on that play.
Merez gets winning. That's one of the things that, if it was just about what play you run or what defense you play, everybody would win. It's not. It's about rebounding. It's about running the floor hard. It's about diving on the floor for loose balls. It's about making not the first effort, but the second effort. And when you become really good, you make the third effort. Will Riley dive on the floor, Merez on the floor. Guys fighting for those things. Those are winning plays. That's what our culture's been here from day one, is figuring out how to make winning plays, not being afraid to make winning plays, sacrificing for your teammates. Merez is a winner. And that's the I can't give him a higher compliment than that. And he's gotten that instilled in him at a very young age. And he's one of the reasons he fits us, so doggone well.
Brad, it's not often you see a team have only 6 points in the paint. You guys had 9 blocks. What did you see in terms of the activity at the rim?
A little better than Alabama, huh? But I think it's an opportunity that for us to continue to grow. We've talked about it since Alabama. I thought we did a poor job in that area. Now, NBA level guards at Alabama. Alabama arguably is one of the 3 or 4 best teams in the country, probably. So it was a good learning lesson for our guys. But I thought our challenges were much better. We didn't stay flat-footed. We took bumps and hits and we clogged it. I was very worried. I mean, you get a scorer averaging 24 a game. And it was about him seeing bodies. And I thought we did a much better job of challenging those.
Towards the end of the game, you got to experiment with Will at the point guard position. I guess, what did you see from him, and what would you like to see with him as the primary ball handler?
Yeah, we do it every day in practice, so it's the first time that, it's not just him. Really, we can play a lot of guys at that spot, but it was just, he was in a pretty good moment offensively. I've always been one of those guys that's going to ride that, and he's got size. He can pop up over people. He's shooting a pretty high percentage from three. Again, they went under, so a lot of it was just jump up and shoot it. But he got downhill. He got in the paint, and those are things that he's very capable of.
Will's had a couple games where it's kind of been a slow start, but then he turns it on in the second half. What's that say about him to handle kind of adversity and be able to bounce back?
Will just hoops. Will just simply, I'm going to use a guy's name, Michael Beasley, that I was around at Kansas State, and nothing phases them. Nothing phases Will. I mean, he had a tough first half. He got at Alabama, and he missed 3 or 4 and easy ones. He missed a wide open 3, he just plays the game. The thing I was the most upset about him in the Alabama game was he took contested 2s with about 20 seconds on the shot clock. I also understand he's probably going to make some of those, but you know, he missed a couple. He had Tommy wide open on one of them for a three. Today, got downhill. When he learns to continue to get fouled, I mean, he's a you know, those are what lottery picks look like. So, but he just plays. Nothing phases him. He plays at the moment. He doesn't play. He's got a gift to not be worried about what I say, not be worried about a missed shot, a bad half. He just plays in the moment, takes what the game gives him, and there's tremendous maturity in that.
Coach, one day prep from Little Rock, have you had a chance to look at film on them, or what are some of the things to expect?
I looked at their defensive possessions before the game of the last night, and very similar. We're going to see a team that mixes up defenses. This is a very good Little Rock team. Let's not forget they could have been an NCAA tournament team last year. I think Moorhead beat them in the championship. They got a lot of guys back. They're very, very long. They're very, very athletic. They got transfers. They're going to play really, really hard. You know, they're like picked to win their league or right there at the top. So, you know, they missed a three. I think they could have got that, made that game pretty interesting last night late. They got down really early, 13, 15, but fought back. And that's a good basketball team, and we're going to have to play better than we did tonight, you know, on the offensive end for sure.
Brad, in the post-game clip we all saw on Twitter from the Illini basketball Twitter feed, you mentioned at the end that today was another chance to get better. What did you see today that made you think you guys got better?
Well, I loved his defensively. And I can't tell you how excited I am about Kylan and what he's doing and the things he's saying. And I saw Casper's take a step today, four steals. And I like our physicality on that end today. I liked our rebounding. Now, that's not one of the better rebounding teams in the country statistically. So it was something we should have done. You know, in a night when you didn't shoot the ball very, very well. And then I thought we did a much better job offensively, you know, kind of moving the ball and playing with pace. And I feel like half the time our guys are stuck in third gear. We haven't got our guys, or second gear maybe. I think we just play too casual offensively. And there was a play tonight where Draven ran to a corner, Ben ran to another corner, and Will got a layup because they ran to the corner. And they did their job. And when we don't run in space, well, then it takes Kylan and Casper and Will. It takes in Trey. It just screws up your whole spacing. And I just feel like we're playing, and I thought the second half improved tonight in that area. It drove me nuts watching us play against Alabama because we never ran. You know, Ben Humerkaus runs a 419 mile. He can run. He can run all day. Run. Trey White can run. Run. Our bigs can run. And we just have to get out of this casual mindset that we're in. And that's I think I saw some improvement there today.
So, Brad, after five games, I wanted to just get your assessment on the team and how they're settling into their roles and just kind of understanding those roles.
I think we're still working on it. I know I am. It's hard because it's you know, some of these games have been like this, and I still want to see combinations. I want to see Kerry and Ben together. I want to see, you know, Merez and a bigger lineup together. You know, I think we've seen a little bit of a smaller lineup. So I think all those things still define roles. I think I'm a little more comfortable now after five games, maybe with substitutions, trying to figure out, you know, I screwed up the other night. And I took KJ and Tommy out at the same time. KJ was cooking in the Alabama game. And I left him out way too long, and I overthought it, to be very honest with you. And that's on me. But I'm starting to get comfortable with my patterns of where they can play and how long they can play and what they can do. And you know, still a long ways to go there.
Brad, obviously a productive night from Trey on the note of roles. What do you want his to look like in terms of what you're asking from him?
Yeah, make open shots, play really hard, guard your tail off, and go get 11 rebounds overnight. And you know, there's going to be opportunities for him there when we space properly to get shots, and he can be a really good driver. I think he missed two right at the rim tonight, but he's a great cutter. He adds that to us. He was, I always go back to our Butler scrimmage. I mean, he just diced him with cuts. But it, again, it's he doesn't have to overhandle. He doesn't have to be a guy who tries to do too much. Just what he did tonight, and he's going to get opportunities to make some threes, and he's a good shooter. But you know, it's, I was really proud of him defensively. That was one of the things that excited me the most.
Coach, Ben takes a high volume of threes. Obviously, he's a good shooter, but there was a play tonight where he kind of attacked a closeout and took it to the rim. What's his complete skill package look like? I don't know what you want to get out of him.
He's very capable. He's very capable. He's I want Ben to be just a efficient player. He's a gravity guy. He's one of the best shooters in college basketball. And I want him shooting. I don't want him ever turning down a three. If he's got a clean look, those are going to become probably harder for him to find as the competition level goes up. Or, you know, if not, teams are going to, he'll make them pay. But he does have the ability to shot fake. You saw him the other night at Alabama, sidestep, you know, shot fake, sidestep for a three. He has the ability to drive that. So he's a really talented offensive player. He's got a pretty complete package on that side.
Just a side note, did you see Ed Cooley's comment?
A guy's told me about it. I mean, that's not even worth wasting my time on, and you know, it's I don't know what he was referencing that about, but you know, and with, you know, Jaden had a productive freshman year here, but I'm not getting into what all that, you know, all that our fans and everybody else have some fun with. I'm sure they probably are, but you're not. I got Arkansas Little Rock to worry about, and Arkansas to worry about, and Northwestern to worry about, and everybody else to worry about. Whether, you know, I don't read your guys' stuff. I'm sure the heck I'm gonna read his.
All right, we'll wrap there.
Thanks.
Thank you.